Good evening, YouTube. Today, I wanted to focus on just a fundamental prim swap, which is, in this case, swapping gloves. So, swapping out gloves for each other, or swapping out gloves for hands, vice versa. So, basically, a prim is a primitive model, and that is essentially the mesh you see in game, like the model itself, Okay, so, the simple mod framework that I have down in the description, download that and put this folder into your Hitman 3 main directory. Let's go right into mods here, and these are all where basically all your mods are stored. So let's just create a new folder, glove swap. Okay, there we go. So basically, let's just sniff into here and basically get a feel for what a mod folder looks like. So content is where all of the main files go, the stuff that's not going to be changed through options, which I'll get to in a second. But basically, the meat and potatoes of the mod goes into the content folder. No mask and standard, in this case, are options for this mod, which allows standard is basically has the mask, and no mask does not. So this manifest.json is arguably one of the most important files. So let's open this up and get a feel for what this is. So version is version of the mod. So, you can just change that if you update it. The ID is important to make sure that is unique for each mod. The name is basically the mod that'll show up in the mod manager. Let me show you in real time. So this is the name right there, and that's the author. So where is it? Okay, yeah, you see the description. And so let's just so basically your description's right here. Framework version, this is the version of, the simple mod framework that, not really that important, but I just keep it at 155 because whatever. So content folder, I always name it content, but that's, that's important too. So these options, basically you see name is, this part. Group outfit selection, so that's basically what appears under settings, because these are settings. Type select, so that basically means that it's this bubble, one or the other standard. You can also do checkbox, you can also do a couple others. You got options. Content folder, so this is the content for this option. So in this case, since you're basically just modifying the temp, which I'll explain in a moment. Here it is. You basically only have a temp and a tblue, and every temp needs its tblue. So a temp is a template file, and a template blueprint is essentially its counter half. Think of it as like a half and half dynamic. Every temp needs a tblue. So we got that layered down. Let's do a glove swap now. So we'll name this glove swap folder. We'll set out content. And for the sake of brevity, we'll just steal one of these manifests and just kind of fill it back out. So let's call this GS name. We will call this glove swap. Description. Very descriptive. So content folder's fine. Framework version, we'll do 5.5 just for shits and gigs. It's really not that important. But so as you can see there, you can add a lot of options. So we're just gonna delete all that, Make sure, you know, everything's closed up here. You know, you got your brackets and your whatnot. So we'll call this glove swap tooltip. Oh, that's one I haven't explained yet. Tooltip is basically when your mouse hovers over it. That's the tooltip, that black box that says removes ballot clavin. I don't know, but that box, that is a tooltip. So whatever you want there, it goes there. Okay, so tooltip. Okay, tooltip. Let's put this is a tooltip group. Yeah, that's okay. Type select. We'll do select this time. Maybe I'll demonstrate checkboxes, but content folder. Let's do GS. We'll name it GS. So, yeah. There's content, and now let's create the folder GS. Okay. So, what's important to note is that whenever you have content that's supposed to go to a certain place, first of all, I should probably explain the runtime system. So, you'll notice how chunk zero patch one, Hitman is broken up into slices, and only chunk zero is loaded for every single all this noise up here. That's basically what the simple mod framework does, but anyways, chunk zero is basically loaded into every single map. So you know, Hitman 1, 2, or 3, it'll all load. Chunk 1, chunk 2, chunk 3, basically they correlate for each level. So in this case, for, you know, for Hitman 2, I believe chunk 1 was Miami, but for Hitman 3, it's, you know, of course, the first map, Dubai. Some of Dubai is also in chunk 0, but you get the drift. Dubai, you know, and then Dartmoor, and, you know. So basically as it ascends, and the only one that is in order is Ambrose Island, which is chunk 28. Basically, that's the chunk system explained. And what's very important to note, because, you know, this is very important for space and other factors and saving a crap ton of time. Chunk zero, because it's being loaded in every single map, you don't need to worry about having dependencies from chunk zero in your mod. Now, I say this with caution because I have tested this, and 90% of the time it works, and then the other 10% of the time where it's like I have nothing, you know, from chunk zero in there, it just crashes. You know, there's no rhyme or reason to it. It just does what it wants, you know. So take that with a grain of salt, you know, like a 90% truth. You know, most of the time chunk zero stuff you don't need to include in your mod. So okay. We don't want to do that. So okay, we're gonna pick an outfit. You could pick an outfit through RPKG editor if you knew how to do that, but to save ourselves some time here, we're gonna use this handy Hitman 3 outfits Google Drive or Google Docs thing. I'm gonna link it in the description. Favorite this, bookmark this, tattoo it on your leg, I don't care. This is a very important site. This has saved me so many hours. So basically, this is like the code name, and then you have the deciphered name more or less over here. So let's just do a simple one. Neon city suit with gloves. Oh yeah, we gotta make sure chunk zero, so all of these outfits we don't have to worry about having their dependencies in there, so we can just have the temps and t-blues. So let's select this template. Copy, and because it's in chunk zero, go to our RPKG editor, go to import, and import chunk0.rpk. So now that chunk zero is loaded, we can throw in our temp, and this is our temp file. So basically, the important thing to remember with pretty much any file in the Hitman files is that they're pretty much like Russian nesting dolls. You know, they all go into each other. You know, pretty much they're all seats. You know, all seats for each other. So this is what I was talking about with Prim, like midnight black suit shoes. You know, a lot of these, you know, are pretty self-explanatory, but you know, then you got a couple oddballs, of course. But so this is pretty much our temp. So we have to see what kind of gloves are being used here, and that is 47 signature suit gloves, season 2 gloves. Okay, so the best way to keep this information for me is Notepad. So I'm gonna do a new text document and save this information. Can make your life easier and just copy it straight from the editor. So that's basically it. And luckily, I have my other text document over here. You'll see the purpose of these numbers in a moment, but I will take this information and throw it over here. Wait, is that a temp? Oh, that's a prim. AT. Oh, okay. Okay, I put the wrong file name. Oopsie daisy. Okay, so let's replace that. There we go. Now I have got it correct. So just a simple prim swap is all we need here, really. So let's go into our let's go into runtime. Mods, where's our mods folder? Simple mods framework, blah blah blah. Okay, glove swap. And get that all primed. So I'm gonna have to see here if it's in chunk 0. It is in chunk 0. Okay, that's good. So because it's in chunk 0, we can just go right into our hex editor. This is HXD. I use HXD. You can do use any hex editor you want, but that's pretty much the, you know, best in my opinion. So let's see. Oh, duh, we need files. So we are going to have to download the. Gets messy. Let's see. Yeah, as you can see, there's a lot of mess with this process. But basically, oh, that is one thing that ha about this document is that sometimes you try to copy off and it just doesn't want to cooperate. And since it's in chunk 0, we don't need to extract hash depends. If it wasn't in chunk 0, we would have to extract recursive hash depends, and that's a whole other thing. But for now, let's just extract the temp. Let's go to runtime. No, we want to go to mods, glove swap, GS. So that's it. And then let's see. Yes, chunk zero. So you can delete this dot meta. Chunk zero dot meta, you don't need that. Delete it. So this is our file, and you're gonna see a whole lot of numbers like these. And it's gonna seem daunting at first, but the thing is that all of these are basically those numbers, but reversed and spaced by 2, which is why I have these numbers. So, you know, 009A 60. You see where this is going. So let's actually write out the prim hex code for this. So 38C6, basically you read it from right to left in order. So 38C6 29 6054 2C A900. Now it does seem a bit frivolous to do it this way, but the RPKG slash hex way has just always worked for me the most. In a later video, I'll probably cover a quick entity editor and a lot of the things that you can do in RPKG, you could do with quick entity editor. But for me and for my needs and just how my computer operates, a lot of this shit just doesn't work on my computer. I have no idea why. But RPKG has always been the most bug-free, the most crap-free, least amount of headaches, you know, with this modding. So, basically, anyways, let's go on here. So, we have the hex code of this. Let's copy it into Control-F for find, put it into the search for thing, and you want to go to hex values and search direction all. Always make sure you have those exact settings or else you'll never be able to find anything. So there it is. We just take this hands prim, copy, and control V, paste. And that is pretty much it, honestly, because it's a prim, so you don't need to alter the T blue. We will make sure to save, close this out. And let's straighten up gotta make sure to mention all content must be in a folder that says chunk zero. I mean, if you're doing something map specific, like modifying a specific map's pets, then it would be, you know, the chunk of that map. But because this is just an outfit to be used on all maps, we're gonna want all of our content to be in chunk zero. So content two, chunk zero, even though there's really nothing here. So let's basically go to this. I mean, technically we really don't need a content folder, honestly. So we'll give, if you just have like one option or just one thing, then you don't need a content folder tag right here. You could just do content GS. So we're going to save this and close this out. And there'll be the dot back there too, of course, but you could just delete that. So let's go to mod manager. Do I have two of them open? Oh, load order manager. Oh, right. I have that one. Okay. So let's disable that one. Glove swap and choose a suit replacement. Save. Apply enabled mods. We just wait for this to deploy, and there we go. Okay, so let's close this out. Close out mod framework, close out that. Got Peacock open. I use Peacock. Obviously, you don't have to use Peacock if you don't want to use Peacock, but I use Peacock. So. Okay, so now we are in game, so let's go into Sapienza. You could really choose any map, but I prefer Sapienza because of the lighting, and we replaced the Neon City suit with gloves right there. So let's go into here and do it. And as you can see, 47 now has nailed. So that is pretty much how you do a prem swap. Just a simple prem swap. In the next video, I'll cover something a bit more complex. So we'll basically take this swapping information and take it to the next level. Until then, goodbye.